dear son. You ask my reaction to long hair or beards on young people. Some great men have worn long hair and beards. George Washington and Abraham Lincoln. If to you long hair or a beard is a symbol of independence, if you believe in your heart that the principles of this country, our heritage, is worthy of this display of pride that all men shall remain free, that free men at all times will not inflict their personal limitations of achievement on others, to demand your own rights as well as the rights of others and be willing to fight for this right, you have my blessing. You ask that I not judge you merely as a teenager, to judge you on your own personal habits, abilities, and goals. This is a fair request, and I promise I will not judge any person only as a teenager. If you will constantly remind yourself that some of my generation judges people by their race, their belief, or the color of their skin, and that this is no more right than saying all teenagers are drunken dope addicts or glue sniffers. If you will judge every human being on his own individual potential, I will do the same. You ask me if God is dead. This is a question each individual must answer within himself. Could a warm summer day, with all its brightness, all its sound, all its exhilarating breathiness, just happen? God is love. Remember that God is a guide and not a stormtrooper. Realize that many of the past and present generation, because of a well-intentioned but unjustifiable misconception, have attempted to legislate morality. This created part of the basis for your generation's need to rebel against our society. With this knowledge, perhaps your children will never ask, is God dead? I sometimes think much of mankind is attempting to work him to death. You ask my opinion of draft card burners. I would answer this way. All past wars have been dirty, unfair, immoral, bloody, and second-guessed. However, history has shown most of them necessary. If you doubt that our free enterprise system in the United States is worth protecting, if you doubt the principles upon which this country was founded, that we remain free, to choose our religion, our individual endeavors, our method of government, if you doubt that each free individual in this great country should reap rewards commensurate only with his own efforts, then it's doubtful you belong here. If you doubt that people to govern us should be selected by their desire to allow us to strive for any goal we feel capable of attaining, then it's doubtful you should participate in their selection. If you are not grateful to a country that gave your father the opportunity to work for his family, to give you the things you've had, and you do not feel pride enough to fight for your right to continue in this manner, then I assume the blame for your failure to recognize the true value of our birthright. Now, I would remind you that your mother will love you no matter what you do, because she is a woman. And I love you too, son. But I also love our country and the principles for which we stand. And if you decide to burn your draft card, then burn your birth certificate at the same time. From that moment on, I have no son.